Good morning. It is September the 21st of 2017. This is the Geyer Cook Report. Ergo, I'm Geyer Cook. Good morning to you if you're following along. In last week on B2B Thursday, I posted up that I saw an ad that was the new, relatively new, 970 by 250 banners that do really well on desktop. I said, well, if you make that banner and you point it at the landing page, of course, then how do you track it? Well, there's a way in Google Analytics to do that, to set up a custom URL. And we're going to take a look at that. The first thing I want you to do is, in the show notes, we've got the link here that says to go to the campaign URL builder. Before you do that, I want you to go here to Custom Campaigns, and this is their glossary. Let me pause this a second. This is their glossary. Sorry about the screen being off. I didn't check that first. Remember the old, if it isn't tested, it doesn't work? Right. Well, that was a good example. There, now that we've said that, Custom Campaigns link that I just showed you here, it's in the show notes, it talks about the vocabulary and explanation of the form that's used to build your URL. So take a look at that first to kind of, I guess, do the homework, how to set up your custom campaign, all the things that you need to know. And I think you'll find that be very, very helpful if you've got an analytics project. Let me pause this again. We'll go back. And we should be back. Yes, we are. Oh, very good. So now, like I was saying, the custom URL builder is available with this link to use. It's the GA Dev Tools, Google Analytics Development Tools. And that link comes up like this form here. And we're going to pause this and adjust the alignment just a minute. Okay, so the custom URL happens with this campaign URL builder. This will let you add the parameters to your URL so that when people click on it, they'll go to the landing page, but more importantly, it'll get tracked in Google Analytics. So whether your referring site is a newsletter, whether it's Google, so let's set one up real quick and show you how easy as cake this is to do. First, we're going to put an https://. Geyer Cook Online Services.com WAC newsletter.html. Now we make sure that link works. We copy it and we'll open a new tab in the browser, like so. We'll paste it into the address bar. This is Firefox. Oh, doesn't work. Very important to test and make sure that you're using a good URL when you build this. And this is kind of a visual aid. So we go to the home page, Geyer Cook Online Services, and we'll say, oh, let's go to services. Okay, that's going to be the landing page we're going to use. So we're going to copy that out of the address bar. As you know, with this keyboard shortcut, Control C. Okay, we'll go back to the form and we'll put in the correct URL. We know this is a good one. And the source is going to be the newsletter. And that's the referring site. You can make a different link and have it be referred by your blog, have a different link be referred by Instagram. Okay, so here's the medium, and because we're going to use that banner size I mentioned before, we're going to call it the banner. And the campaign name, I've used the month, so let's say September. Oh, wait a minute, that's month we're already in. Let's plan ahead and do it for October. So we're going to put 2017-10 as the campaign name. the campaign term, identify the paid keywords. Well, we don't have any because we're just doing it yet. And the campaign content, if you want to differentiate the ads, like maybe you're doing A-B testing, something like that. So we're going to call this A version. Oops. You want to have separate words, you separate them with a dash, not an underline, because then it'll make A version all one word. So now, the campaign URL that we created by filling out this form is dynamically, part of me wants to say automatically, but dynamically created right here in this box. So you just copy this URL, go right there, copy it, right? And then you go about adding it to the banner that's going to appear in your newsletter. And we'll talk about how to do that in another episode of the show. But I hope that gets you started. That gives you enough brain food. And again, there it talks about all the different parameters that you've got in the link. And you'll see them in the source. If you go to the source code and you look at the thing right there, UTM source, this newsletter. Okay, that's the same value that we put right here. So, bazinga, there you have it. Campaign URL builder. Hope that helps you in your efforts. Of course, there's a number of other things involved, and we'll go through those over time on other B2B Thursdays. But this will save you a couple of shekels by doing it yourself instead of hiring it done. So, let's go back to the show notes. On B2B Thursday for today, on September 21st, we've got a number of links in here, as we oftentimes do. The Geiger Cook Report questions. Pick five of those, follow the instructions, we'll do an interview. Make your company more transparent. Because basically, people buy from people they know. And so the more they know about you, maybe they don't know that you like to fly fish. So hey, they go, well, you know, there's a lot of web developers, but this guy fly fishes. I fly fish. So we can talk about fishing, and we'll maybe be on the same page as a result of that common knowledge. Planning session guide, take a look in there for the brain food that you're going to have for making your effort better. And I think that the years I've spent developing this are going to give you a good plan, and good websites are born from good plans, so why not have one? Thanks to the patrons. There's a link there on the side, be my patron on Podbean. The link on Podbean is going to take you to this result. Let me move this up just a little bit, just to pause here. And as you can see, the Podbean patronage is by the month. So I'd ask you, if you donate $1 a month, you're going to get 20-some episodes of the Geiger Cook Report. And it helps us in our efforts to do this. So let's conclude that shameless plug. I'll be right back. And so we're back. Thanks for joining us today. You can see in the show notes, there's the links there to all the people that we thank, like Fraser Ramsey, who's on holiday in Cyprus. That's a Facebook to search. He represents Edinburgh Duster's company that likes to clean. So if you're on that side of the ocean, give him a look. Thanks to Eileen Smith, who told me about Screencast-O-Matic. Her blog, one of them is basicblogtips.com. There's pearls in that oyster. So visit the Digital Diva on her site. The Friends Just Chatting group on Facebook, thanks for listening to us today. Subscribe to us if you're on YouTube. Check out our feed on the GeigerCookReport.podbean.com, like it shows right there. That's going to give you RSS you need for your RSS reader. And like it says at the end of every show, thanks for listening to the September 21st episode of the Geiger Cook Report B2B Thursday. It's a wrap.